Been so much discussion about testing in general. Listened to Senator Romney earlier. I think Senator Kane mentioned it. Everybody has. Dr. Hahn, if you remember when we first met, I said, is the FDA going to be more entrepreneurial? Is the FDA going to kind of not be as stodgy? Talking then about how we fix the healthcare system in general. Now this has brought it into clear focus. I've got a timeline that I'm going to submit for the record that shows from January 24th through March 5th, and I want to emphasize what Senator Burr asked earlier, has the administration ever put an impediment in front of trying to get to testing? And Dr. Hahn, this will end up in a question in a moment, but there was a span of time from January 24th through March 5th that I hope the American public looks at. And it gets back to what's wrong with our healthcare system in general. Early testing, from what I'm seeing, was created by the fact that the CDC said it was going to do its own test. The South Korean test that gets cited so often was not going to be looked at. We had to do our own. I know the FDA worked with the CDC, but the long and short of all of this is that for nearly a month, this was in that bureaucratic swirl. The FDA prevented private and academic development of tests for weeks. The CDC denied access to functioning tests, as I cited in South Korea. This created, through all the red tape and bureaucracy, to where we had to come up with a one-size-fits-all approach due to the uncertainty of the virus, and we are stuck with that now. I don't want to dwell on that necessarily because I think those were mistakes that we made. I'm tired of having it heard that it's the administration's fault. Dr. Hahn, I'd like to ask you this question. In that spirit of what we talked about during your nomination process, here going forward, will we shed some of that stodginess? Will we look to get therapeutics and vaccines through the system in a quicker method? Because I fear if we don't, and if we treat through bureaucracy how we did the early period of testing, we can belabor this into the distant future, and at that point there's going to be not only the carnage from the disease itself but from the economy to deal with. So I'd like your comment on that 1 month stretch, what accountability the FDA and the CDC have, and then whether it looks better in terms of moving more quickly into the future.
Thank you, Senator Braun, for the question. Our timeline of that period demonstrates that we began working with test developers beyond CDC on January 24th and had double-digit number of test developers working with us. One of the issues that we identified was, in fact, availability of the virus and other supplies to actually get that test development done in a timely fashion. Senator, I completely agree with you that this is an opportunity for us to take a look and determine how we can do things better. And I think that's a really important thing for all of us to do. And certainly the FDA, I can promise you, will do that. Looking forward, sir, I can commit to you that we will look at every one of our regulatory authorities. We have done so during this outbreak. We have provided significant flexibility and have tried to provide the right balance between regulatory flexibility and enabling of the great test developers and therapeutic developers in this country with the need to ensure that our gold standard of safety and efficacy is in place. We have leaned in with manufacturers. We've learned a lot from them as well as the other stakeholders, and we will continue to learn, and we will, I commit to you, sir, implement the changes that are necessary to make sure that we can act in a more nimble way, but still protect the safety and efficacy of medical products.